paveikslai neturi būti vien tik tai gražus, gėlytės, drugeliai. Ir tai yra sunkesnis kelias, sakyčiau. Tai aš esu Slavinskaitė tapytoja ir baigiau tapybą, bakalaurą Kaune, magistrantūrą Vilniuje ir dabar čia tapau, kuriu, kviečiu kitus ateiti, pasižiūrėti ir patapyti kartu. Dabar gyvenu Pilaitėj, daugiabutyje. Meluočiau, jeigu sakyčiau, kad tai mano pirma patirtis gyvenant ten daugiabutyje. Kulautuvai savo miške irgi 10 metų ten pragyvenau, bet vis tiek buvo ne tas. Vis tiek jaučiuosi dabar be galo svetima tame Pilaitės betonų rajone. Bet daugiausia laiko praleidžiu čia senamestį centre, aplink studiją. Vaikai manęs būna klausia, mokytojai, jūs čia ir gyvenate ir miegate čia? Tai būna labai jokinga tai išgirsti. Svarbu visionuoti nuolat vykstantį gyvenimą aplinkui, atspindėti jį, galbūt metaforomis, bet visada tai yra dėmesys sutelkiamas daugiausiai į žmogaus psichologinį portretą, jo būsenas. Ir gal kai kurie žmonės, kuriuos aš nutapau, nelabai net norėtų būti taip pavaizduoti, galbūt savęs taip nemato, bet aš perfiltruoju per save ir tokia išeina rezultatai.
Hello, I am Linas Kaziulionis, painter and mural artist. My created works can tell more about who I am. My work is me. It reflects my interests, my values, my thoughts, and my personality. My work is painting and mural artworks, which often intertwine with each other. In both paintings and street art, I develop fake news themes, examine conspiracy theories, use the observation of modern anthropology, and like to use appropriation. The topics I study are from the environment I study, so in mural art images, the viewer also recognizes current topics seen in the news or social networks, interpreted artistically and at the same time inviting to think more deeply, often using iconic visuals of classical art. Mural art is like large canvases, which are already widespread from Italy to Thailand, from Kosovo to the USA.
Klaipėda, and we are going to my my village, where I happen to have a studio in my second year, second semester. And now I have to pick up one of my works from there. So I thought I would just bring you along. This highway and driving in general, I think, is a very big part of my life. And now it became one of the main topics in my practice as well.
To answer that every day, I guess. I'm an artist, I'm a painter, but also I'm a dancer and I'm a performance artist. But I guess the foundation of it all is painting. And even when I dance, I think of the same principles that painter does, about the color, space, composition, about textures, all that kind of stuff. As you can see, I don't really have a studio space and I work in my garage. But I guess it's not really about the space, it's about the way you use it, and that applies to many things in life. And I guess you just have to be creative with everything that you do and then it will be easier.
My name is Eglė Marcinkevičiūtė.
Hello.
Sometimes I like to paint sunlight, especially different versions of sunlight, and I want to mark the beginning of dialogue between the light and me, so you can listen and analyze these multiple versions of me.
Hello, this is Lisette. I don't really like making videos of myself, so I'm just gonna show you what keeps me sane these days.
My name is Caroliina Luhamets and I'm an artist from Estonia. If I were to describe myself and my art, I really want to make something that matters to me at first. Because every time when I make something, I go really deep into myself and I like to understand why I do things like I do. I think a lot about my past and my childhood, who has influenced me. It gives me so much pleasure to figure out things in my own way and showing it in my paintings. I have values in life that matters to me, like people around me and my teachers, and the school has had a big influence on me in a good way. I also think about being an artist and why I want to be an artist, why I want to make art. But I have this big force inside me that I really want to accomplish things, and I have big dreams that I want to make. Even if I have a big dreams, I sometimes doubt myself. When these things happen to me, like this competition, it really makes things real and gives me some kind of confidence to continue in this field. Because I really like painting and I really like to think about the world and the people, and I love people deeply and I want to understand their thoughts and emotions, and it influences me and my paintings. I'm already so thankful to be in this competition. So hopefully you can hear more about me in the future. I'm really thankful already.
Human beings are organisms created by nature. Those organisms are influenced by both inside and outside irritations, emotions, and everyday life. I think humans are quite complicated systems, and they have roots that go way, way back in time. And actually, my art practice is based on what is human being, who am I, and I think I deal with this kind of topic every day.
I'm a creative person. I like to develop ideas visually. The ideas dictate the medium for me. The images and objects depicted in the series decaying testify to the presence of death, decaying, aging, and unworthy elements and remnants of life. I'm very happy to participate in the Young Painter Prize exhibition. Thank you for considering me for the entertainment prize.
I'm Andris Kalinins. I am from Riga. I'm a painter and scenographer, and usually when I start to work on new exhibition or theater piece, I am trying to get inspired in some of world's biggest art museums, and also today I'm in Budapest Museum of Fine Arts to meet Anton van Dyck and also other painters and their paintings. That's instead of being in my studio, because this research part is as important in my case and in my vision as working on painting in my studio. Pedos.
Anton Pedos.
Yes, exactly.
So who you said you are?
I'm an artist.
So you are an Ukrainian artist?
Yes.
But why didn't you choose something that is really helpful for your country right now?
What do you mean?
Why you didn't choose something that society needs?
You think art is not important for society?
Okay, never mind. So you finished the Academy of Arts?
Yes.
And what is next?
Good question. I don't know.
Well, it seems that you don't have any plans for your life. Why are you here in Lithuania still? Why you're not in Ukraine, or why you're not defending your country?
Because I'm afraid.
So you think that making your art is enough?
I don't say that.
Okay, the last question for you. Who is asking the stupid questions?